Please subscribe to UiPath Expo Hub channel and hit the bell icon. Be the first person to watch the latest automation videos. Hello friends. Today we are going to learn about double split. UiPath VV.NET double split. How to do that and what is the meaning of double split is something I am going to teach you. Myself Rakesh from UiPath Expo Hub. Please do subscribe to our channel if you are a new visitor. Please do like all the videos that you're watching. That is something we expect from all our viewers. One like is what we need. Thank you very much. So let's get started. So double split, right? What is the necessity of a double split? For example, in a notepad, I am taking a simple example. His name is Mr. Rakesh. Okay. So here what I want, if you do a split, let's say split by space, if I do, what would happen? So generally split by space when I do, it's going to give me his name is Mr. Rakesh, right? So there will be four different output, right? If you do a simple split, but I want only Rakesh. So this particular word has two things, Mr. dot Rakesh, right? So I have to somehow find a way to remove that and get the exact output I want. So that is called double split in UiPath VV.NET. So how to do that? It's to be very interesting. So please continue for a couple of minutes and you will be learning that. Okay. So for that, so the very first thing I'm doing is read text activity. I'm pointing to that notepad file where I have the name. Remember, while you type anything, let's say you are making some change while you are learning, you might be putting different sentences. So when you do it, ensure you save it. Okay. Because if you do not save and try to run it, it will be a problem. So better you save it. Remember this small point. And after that, once you read the text, you know, I am driving that value to a variable called input variable. I'm passing that. So input variable is the value which will contain whatever writings you have done in your notepad. Done. After that, here is the technique I have to implement. Output variable where I want to see the exact output. So how to write is something we need to understand. Okay. So let me show you. So I taught you in the previous chapter how to do the split, right? I shown you three different ways. So I'm going to use one of the way that is called split. And here in the bracket, I'll use the variable. What is my variable name? Input variable is the name of my variable, comma, then your delimiter, right? Which would define how you want to split. So I'm defining, I'm giving a hitting on space. Okay. So when I do on hit on space, what would happen? My entire word will get divided as per the space. So there will be four different words, right? His is one word, name is the second word, is the third, and the last one is Mr. Rakesh. So everybody, all these words will be arranged in an array format, right? So how the array format would look? The array format would look something like his name is Rakesh, Mr. Rakesh, right? This is how the array format will appear. Now, excuse me for the capitals that I've written. So it will be as is. Okay. So this is how it will appear. So it will become an array. Now I want to retrieve the, so this is called the index number 0, the first one. First result is 0, index number 1, 2, 3. So the third result is going to contain Mr. Rakesh, correct? So if I see, if I say here in the bracket, simply by typing 3, what would happen? Out of that 4 results, the last one will be shown to me. So you have to know what is your input and how you want to get it, right? So here I've defined 3, click on OK, and here I wanted to hit on run. So what would happen? My output, okay, something went wrong. Do you know what is that? So let's dock it and then you can hit on auto hide. Okay, so here what happened, my output is now single character, right? So if I go to variable, ensure this is string. So I don't know if I, let me delete this and hit on save once. And here why there is error, split input variable comma 3, which is correct. So what is the error all about? Let me see that. One or more children have validation error or warnings. Okay, compiler error encountered processing expression split input variable comma and space 3. Okay, so one thing I can do, let me write here dot to string if that problem arises. Dot to string. Okay. I understood. This is not required. What happened? My variable, what I'm declaring here, right? If you see, I have written a wrong spelling because of that. Okay. So ensure your whatever variable you are typing, it is in the right spelling is correct. Otherwise, you will have problem. Okay. So the error is gone. So let me run it. All right. So now what is happening? It's showing me Mr. Rakesh. Okay, now what I want to do a double split. That means split within a split. So what I'm going to do here, let me teach you. So this is what I want to teach you. So here, what you do, now you understood how this split is written. So you write split in the bracket, you give the variable name and you put your delimiter how it should divide and then which character you want, right? So that is how you write it. So here what I'm going to do, I'm going to consider the entire output as my input variable. Okay, so this will become my input. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to write split and I'm going to put everything into bracket and entire thing will become my input. So I'll put a comma. Understanding? So that is how you have to think. Okay, so everything will become my input now. Okay, so this is your input and then how I want to the delimiter. So the delimiter here is dot, Mr. dot Rakesh, right? So I'm putting a delimiter. So now what is going to it will do, it is going to divide the entire word Mr. Rakesh into Mr. and Rakesh. There will be two outputs, right? So out of those two outputs, I want to see the 01 output, which is the name, right? So if I'm writing one means the name, so it will divide into two things, Mr. Rakesh. So Mr. is 0, index number 0, and Rakesh will store in the index number 1 of the array, right? So I want the 1. So if I click on OK and try to run it, now you will see because of the double split, it's going to provide me only Rakesh as the output. Okay. So in the coding, you might see, you saw, right? Rakesh has come as the output. Okay, so Rakesh has come as the output, we can see that. So anytime anywhere in the code, if they have written like this, you might get completely confused, 3 1, what is this, right? So this is the correct explanation that you must have got. So let me recap once again. So first thing what I'm doing, I'm just writing the first internal one. So split your variable, your input variable, and how I want to split and which character I want as an output. Done. After that, I am putting again split over the everything and considering the entire thing as my input. So Mr. Rakesh is becoming the input and here I am putting a dot to divide Mr. dot Rakesh into two different parts, right? It will split it and then I want this second part. So second means the index number will be 1. Okay, so that is how, so all your index starts from 0, 1, 2, 3 like that. It always starts from 0, not 1. Okay, so I'm writing 1 here. So the second part of my output is has come and I can show the output. So this is one of the very interesting and very, very useful thing that you need to know. Okay, like that I am going to come up with small bytes of such VV dot and information. And I am sure once you are good with some 10-20 different VV.NET expressions, you will be very strong. You will feel very strong to even attend the interviews, right? So please do watch. As I always request you guys, one like what we need. Please do like our videos. That is what as a team of we working on this and trying to get information for you. That's what we would expect, that all our viewers would, you know, hit on the like button. Please do that. Please do not forget. Thank you very much. You guys have a wonderful day.